Well, let's turn to far north Queensland now, where residents have begun the clean-up in the wake of Cyclone Kirrily. 9 Queensland reporter Jacob Chico brings us up to date from Townsville.
Good morning, Chris. Well, at the peak of this yesterday, there were 66,000 customers left in the dark as a result of the tropical cyclone that passed through here on Thursday night. But speaking to Ergon workers this morning, crews made some really significant progress after working through the night. And this morning, it's now less than 50,000 customers without power. Really, the headaches for workers at the moment are the hundreds of trees that are scattered across the area and the plenty of power lines that are down. We're at Ergon Energy this morning and we are awaiting the arrival of Premier Stephen Miles. He's meeting with energy workers this morning for a breakfast before crews head out again for what will be another very busy day. 100 Ergon workers on the ground will be supported by 600 other reinforcements who have come here to Townsville to provide a much-needed helping hand. Sadly, the job is a big one, so customers in those affected areas across North Queensland are being told in some cases to prepare for at least 7 days without power as crews work really hard to try and restore the power in those affected areas. Chris, we will update you later in the show after speaking with the Premier and Ergon later in the morning.
Well, for more, let's bring in Chris Hooper from Ergon Energy. Chris, thanks so much for your time. Where are you seeing the most damage?
Damage is quite widespread across Townsville in terms of that's where we've got the majority of our customers off at the moment. But south of Ingham was hit quite hard and also in the Home Hill area as well.
Chris, we just heard that it could be up to 7 days before some residents actually get their power back. What's the timeline that you're seeing?
Well, we had 66,000 customers off at the peak of the event. We're down to just under 50,000 as it stands at the moment. We had about 100 resources on the ground yesterday locally, responding to critical infrastructure and damage assessment. We've got a lot of the damage assessment done. We've got additional resources coming in today. We're hoping we'll have really a few quick wins over the next 2 days and majority of customers supplied back on from network from Saturday and Sunday.
But it could be up to 7 days for some residents?
The residents in the rural areas where we're seeing a lot more damage to infrastructure, there could be access issues and those sorts of things. We're saying 7 days just to make sure that our customers are prepared to have their supply for a longer period. But we're working as hard as we can. We'll have majority of customers back on over the next 2 days and we'll work through those harder to access customers
Chris, we know it's a big couple of days ahead for your workers, so we thank you so much for your time.
Well, let's get the latest now on ex-tropical cyclone Kirrily that's left tens of thousands without power in North Queensland. Senior meteorologist Miriam Bradbury joins us now live from the Weather Bureau, as well as Townsville resident Gail Rowe. Good morning to you both. We'll start with you, Miriam. What is the latest on the system? Where is it and is it causing any trouble?
So, ex-tropical cyclone Kirrily is currently located across the northern inland of Queensland. We do still have a warning current which is flagging the risk of heavy falls and potential flash flooding in those areas. It touches a number of districts including the Gulf Country, the northern goldfields and upper Flinders, the northwest and the central west, and it's likely that the ex-tropical cyclone will move very slowly across those same areas over the weekend. That means that risk of heavy falls and further flooding is likely to continue across the weekend across those northern inland parts of the state.
How serious and how likely is that threat of flooding?
It is very serious and very likely. We're already seeing flooding across the state. We've got a number of minor flood warnings already current, with one major flood warning across catchments which have been seeing that rainfall from first the cyclone and then the ex-tropical cyclone as it moves inland. We do still have large parts of the state covered by a flood watch, which does indicate that we could see further river rises thanks to this rainfall.
Well, Queenslanders do know what this is like. Let's talk to one now. We'll bring in Gail, who was without power until last night. Gail, how long did it take for you to get reconnected?
Took about somewhere between 11 and 12 hours. Fortunately, we had a generator, but 4 hours into it, it decided not to work anymore.
Now, we know everybody's saying how thankful they are that the damage from Cyclone Kirrily was not what was predicted, but can you describe what it was like as that Category 3 made landfall?
Best word for it, noisy. Very anxiety-provoking. You've got whirling winds, trees moving around all over the place, breaking. When they break, they crack. You've got a slow build-up to the winds that you're seeing on the screen now. And then you go through the eye, and you know that you're about to have the 140, 120K winds. But then it hits very suddenly. There's no build up or anything inside. You kind of go, I can't do this again. But you have to just ride it out, and you wait until the morning, and then you assess the damage. One of the things that I asked a lot of friends around, and I said, how'd you go last night? How do you feel this morning? And the common word is, I'm tired.
Yeah.
You can't sleep.
Yeah, the anxiety of all that. We are thinking of you all, and it is good news that the damage was a lot less than people predicted. Gail, and also to Miriam Bradbury from the Bureau, thanks for your time.
Just under 50,000 residents in North Queensland are right now without power still, following Cyclone Kirrily's ferocious landfall on Thursday night.
For the very latest, let's bring in Acting Commissioner Steve Smith from Queensland Fire and Emergency Services. Good morning to you, Steve. First of all, can you bring us up to date on what's happening in the affected areas?
Yeah, so across the affected areas, we've had crews out supporting damage assessment and understanding where the best impact for response is. Remarkably low levels of significant damage. There's a lot of power lines, wind and water damage. State Emergency Service calls overnight has been approximately 270, and they've largely been about debris from trees, vegetation, and some tarping operations. So again, the community's sort of moving around, clearing itself up and getting back to some normality. A lot of power still out through those areas, so crews are working hard to restore that, but a really quite low impact in all things considered.
And no doubt anxious times the last few days for residents, but that's good news to hear this morning. More immediately, or most immediately, what are the crews up to today, and where are the hotspots?
Yeah, so we've still got our swift water crews out and positioned across the impact area, because there is still water moving through those catchments, and we did have an incident overnight. But crews are out continuing damage assessment, making sure access is cleared and people's properties are able to return to some normality. So they're assisting in the recovery operations as best they can. We've got significant resources in the area to support that.
We know that there was concern that the system as it moved through would bring a lot of heavy rain. What is happening right now today, and where is the main area of concern from the rain?
Yeah, so the system itself is out west of Winton at this stage and is expected to slow down somewhat today. So there's still rainfall out through those regional western Queensland, and that's bringing river rises and isolating people, and they're well prepared for that. But again, they're communities that are used to isolation, prepare well for it, but they will be isolated for some time. And that will continue through the next course as it moves towards the Northern Territory.
In terms of preparedness, Steve, what we've seen over the last few months, it's been a torrid time for people in far north Queensland. Have you been impressed with what you've seen?
Look, the crossing of TC Kirrily and the impacts of it, the preparedness of the community is why we've had no loss of life, no serious injuries reported. People have been, got on the front foot ahead of the season, in the lead up to the event, and then they heeded the information warnings and advice of authorities, and that's made the difference. So I'm incredibly pleased that the community has responded that way, and it's a lesson for us all into the future. It's a great outcome.
And is there any further advice for residents in those areas?
Oh, look, still prioritise your safety. There's still hazards out through the area, both in terms of water, in terms of power lines. Any power lines on the ground, treat as live. And just as much as you can, stay off the roads, because you've got crews trying to assist in those recovery operations, restore essential infrastructure, and that helps everyone get back on their feet. So if people can stay off the roads and provide that access, that's a real benefit for everyone.